study Sicily, gentlemen. Our target for today is the coastal battery near Catania. We gotta fly to Catania and do what we do best. Here come the Italians. Don't engage them if you can help it. Our objective is more important. Our ships are under attack! Attack!
Somebody attack that target! Proceed to current objective. Stand by for orders.
Negative. Affirmative.
Thank you.
job. Now flying around here will be easier.
Lanciati con il paracadute.
Owen Wright's diary, June 15th, 1943. I thought I knew it all by now, but today I learned to boom and zoom. I almost blacked out a couple times due to the effects of repeatedly diving and climbing. But Corporal Tuck told me to curl my toes up in my boots, and it worked. The Italian planes look like a pride of leopards. It's a very unusual paint job, but surprisingly effective. It was a real strain to pick them out above the coastline. When we did eventually get to the coastal battery, I actually led the small attack formation myself for a while. I was so proud and hoped to become a squadron leader by the time this war is over. Being away from Britain for the first time has made me realize how much I love my country. Sicily looks pretty down there, but I am dying for one of my mother's roast dinners.
Gentlemen, our target for today is located deep behind enemy lines. If you sight an enemy plane, don't think. Attack him right away. Attention fighters, straight ahead. There's his plane. I see it. Descend the lines alongside. only got two Johnsons in my pod cockpit. Come on, take off. Mission is simple. First, get to the airfield. Second, third, and most important, get back in one piece. Right will provide cover. Go in. Roger that. Destroyers up ahead. Good find. Let's get them before they cause any trouble. Hope the airfield will be just as easy. Attention, bandits. We'll cover you.
We're on target.
There's the airfield. Let's get to it, boys. Stay close to the target. The flak is too heavy. Watch out, more fighters.
Just make one up!
Hanno preso uno dei nostri!
This is USS Bonnet. Enemy ships straight ahead. Take care of them. Otherwise, we cannot proceed with the landing. Is approaching. Intercept them.
Roger, we'll go.
Is in jeopardy. Another flight of bandits. Get them now.
Roger that.
Thank you.
landing. You're cleared to RTB.
Roger that, sir. Have a nice day.
Speed up.
An excerpt from the diary of Robert Johnson, July 11, 1943. I wasn't in the mood to fly today. All I could think about was my beautiful wife and precious new daughter. But you gotta do what you gotta do. And I couldn't have my little girl hearing her papa was a deserter. My heart was pounding as I dispatched off three destroyers and then found the new 109G in my sights. You can say a lot about the Germans, but they sure know how to build a plane. I took some heavy flak, and I didn't know if my Mustang would hold together. But nothing was going to stop me getting home to my girls. I just managed to limp back to base and got a dressing down from my mechanic for the state of the fuselage. Jeez. I'm no coward, but all of a sudden this war seems even crazier than it did before.
Thank you.
sec. Come on, let's hit them. Roger that.
Come on.
Diary of Robert Johnson, July 12, 1943. The guys were saying the Huns cuff tank drivers to their instruments to stop them climbing out and running away, after seeing the Italian tank column collapse like tin cans today. I can see why they have to. What if it was me in there? What if those guys also had a baby and a wife, waiting at home? When we got to Primosole and saw the damage done to our bridgehead, I soon put the thoughts out of my mind. I was fighting for our wives and children, not theirs. The Messerschmitts came back with a vengeance, and we lost a fair few guys before we could get to safety. I still haven't seen Owen return tonight. I hope he's safe. I'm thinking of asking him to be Emily's godfather. The Battle of Stalingrad was the ultimate turning point on the Eastern Front. Germany would never fully recover. The war was now for the Soviets to lose. They had many difficult battles ahead, with the ultimate goal of not only liberating occupied Soviet territories, but taking the war all the way to Berlin and wiping out the Nazi regime once and for all. By the winter of 1944, a large salient formed on the front line of the Ukraine. Centered around the town of Korsun, the salient was defended by two German armies. Both sides concentrated large forces in this small area, including dozens of divisions, thousands of tanks and heavy guns, and hundreds of thousands of soldiers. Soviet High Command planned a complex operation with two simultaneous pincer attacks from the flanks and a subsequent encirclement of the German defenders. German forces inside were to be surrounded and wiped out, Stalingrad style. The operation was meant to deal another heavy blow to the German war effort, and pave the way for the Soviet advance into Germany itself.
Targets of the artillery guns nearby. We'll fly south along the river. Stay in formation.
Противник!
Undecided.
Attack! 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 Attack!
There are Germans on the other side, too.
We'll deal with them, too.
Thank you.
target. Look, fuel trucks, a whole fleet. Danilo, look at that. Oh, I know for it.
How delicious. Not even camouflaged. We can't just pass this by, can we? Let's hit them.
Andrew Dunlop's diary, January 25th, 1944. The Germans are digging their heels in, but they must surely be close to breaking. We targeted their encampment on the River Ross in the Ukraine and obliterated the artillery batteries with no problem. Things became a lot more difficult, however, when a group of Fritz 190s targeted my comrade Nefedov. His rear gunner was killed in the attack. And he was fighting to stay alive until I could get to him. Of course, they didn't stick around long after I arrived. Hearing his calls over the radio as he begged for help brought back a lot of memories from this war. It never gets any easier to see a fallen comrade, and I pray each night that there will be no more funerals in my homeland. We finished our mission destroying a procession of uncamouflaged fuel trucks. The Germans may not be finished yet, but they're getting lazy.
Germans broke through. Panzer is moving in our direction. Our orders are to stop the breakthrough.
Enemy fighters up ahead.
Great. Let's move on.
attack run. Daniel Slide, abort the mission. Repeat, abort the mission. You are attacking friendly forces. I say again, Daniel Slide, abort, abort. You are hitting friendly tanks. Storm a weak spot. Wrong with you. You've wounded our commander. Stand by for victory to enemy panzers.
Everything seems to be in order now.
Attention! Ground crews report several must intercept them.
Andrew Dunlop's diary, February 10th, 1944. Like a juggernaut, the Germans made a break for it today, moving their panzers along the ground and trying to distract us with the Fokker Wolfs in the skies. My squadron did me proud as ever, and we split duty between the two in order to stop their escape. We nearly had a tragedy when we approached our second target. The panzers in our sight turned out to be our own tanks. Fortunately, my eagle eyes picked them out before we dropped, and ground control could give us the correct enemy vector instead. His Junker 52s fled the scene, and taking them out was like shooting fish in a barrel. I've been sent back to base to get some rest, but to be honest, I could have done that all day. On June 6, 1944, Operation Overlord was launched in Western Europe. Combined U.S., British, and Canadian forces landed in Normandy, poised to liberate France and put an end to Nazi rule in Europe. The Allied bridgehead soon expanded, and Operation Overlord finally ended on August 25th with the liberation of Paris. By early fall, the Allied advance moved into Belgium. However, by December, the much-hoped-for Christmas victory did not materialize. And then, on December 16th, Germany launched a large-scale surprise attack in the Ardennes. German forces hoped to make up for their numerical disadvantage with the element of surprise. If the Wehrmacht managed to strike deep into the Allied rear and split their forces in two, the entire Western Front could be in jeopardy.